I am your biology teacher, Saraswati Devi. So today we are going to start your 12th portion. So biology subject, two parts it will be there. Already you know that. Biobotany part A and part B, biozoology. Part A, biobotany having 5 units, unit 6 to unit 10. Same manner in the biozoology, units 5 totally and unit 1 to unit 5. So today class we are going to see about the biobotany Chapter 1, asexual and sexual reproduction in plants. So reproduction, what is reproduction? Reproduction is the vital process. So it can be seen in all the living things and it is useful for the existence of the species. And this is bring the suitable changes in the organism to the variation and evolution in the offspring. Okay, this survival of the thing, reproduction, it is required only for plant, not all the organisms directly or indirectly depending the this plants only. So plant reproduction is very essential one. Then basically the reproduction, it will be classified into two types, asexual reproduction and sexual reproduction. So first we can see the asexual reproduction. So what is asexual reproduction? Here there is no involvement of the gametes. So in this type of the reproduction we can see in lower organisms, for example algae, fungi and animals. Some lower animals only we can see these asexual reproduction. So and what method it will be producing? So first one, gonidia. Gonidia it will be produced in fungus, that is example Aspergillus and Penicillium. Budding, yeast and hydra. Fragmentation, Spirogyra. Then production of germinate, Marchantia. Regeneration seen in Planaria and binary fission in Bacteria. So this asexual reproduction means single parent it will be involved. So there is no gamete fusion is occurred, that's why it is not involving any gametes in this reproduction. So the individuals which will be morphologically and genetically identical. So when it is the individual is morphologically and genetically identical, it is called as clones. Clones, it is the important question. And now we are going to discuss about the higher plants reproduction. Then that higher plants reproduction, it will show some different method. Okay, that vegetative method, it will be shows that different. So that higher plants vegetative reproduction, that is asexual reproduction, the first they produce the buds. Okay, this buds where it will be produced in the plants means roots or stem or leaf, any part of the plant it will be produced. But when it is getting the favorable condition, no, in that time it will be detached and it will be grow into the new plant. Okay, and this buds, okay, sometime it will be used for the vegetative propagation and also it will be useful for storage and perination. Okay, storage means excess reserve food material it will be stored in that particular region. Perination, perination means many year living. Okay, the plant it will be an annual plant also. So but again when it is getting the favorable condition, no, again it will be germinated and produced in the new plant. Okay. Then the unit it will be used for the propagation, no. So that's why that propagation used reproductive vegetative part it will be called vegetative propagules or diaspore. Okay. Vegetative part is useful for the propagation. So that again it will be called as reproductive propagule or diaspore. Then vegetative reproduction, so it will occur in roots. Some plants we can see the root region it will be useful for the vegetative propagation through the adventitious buds it will be produced in their roots. Muraya, Dalbachia, Millingtonia is the example. Then some tuberous roots, for example Hypomia, Patatas, Dahlia, in this the tuberous roots it will be produced in some buds. Okay, but the tuberous root it will be stored in the food material. That portion it will be used for the vegetative propagation. Okay, so this vegetative propagation used the organs. It will be taken in the root portion. See here, Muraya plant. Muraya plant roots it will be grows the new buds it will be produced and it will be go into the new individual plant. Next one, Vegetative reproduction means stem region. Okay, the stem portion involved in the vegetative reproduction. So the stem, which stems it will be useful for this type of the asexual reproduction means, especially we can see in underground stem and superior stems. Okay, first we can see the underground stem modification, it will be useful for the vegetative reproduction. Rhizome, Musa paradisiaca, Gingivora officinalis, Curcuma lana. Okay, this three will be useful for the vegetative propagation. It is the underground stem, that underground stem only called as rhizome. Next one, palm. Amorphophyllus and Colocasia is the example. Then tuberous, Solanum tuberosum, bulb, Allium sheafa and Lilium. See here, tuberous root. Tuberous root, potato, Solanum modification. And it is underground stem modification, ginger is the example. Then corn example, Colocasia, pulp example, onion and garlic. Then now come to the superior stem modification. Superior stem, it will be useful for the reproduction. Okay, that modification. The first one, runner, Central Asiatica, Stolen, Menta and Fragaria, Opsa pistia and Iconia, Sucker Chrysanthema, Bulbis, Diasporia and Adi. So in here, axillary buds of the rhizome, it will be useful for the produce in the end vine. And same manner, tuber. Okay, that Solanum tuberosum, they having a high spot, it will be useful for the produce in the next generation. So here they given the runner example, Centrella asiatica. Then stolen example. Okay, the root system it will be given the next generation. Where the node it will be coming out in that portion, it will be giving the root in the which portion it is touching the soil, and above portion it will be giving the shoot system. Then come to the offset. Offset it will be a, it is also underground stem because half of the portion it will be seen the above the water level and half of the portion it will be seen in water. So this is pistia also example. Then sucker, Chrysanthema is the example. Then Diasporia is the example for the bulbs. Then third type of the reproduction. Okay, vegetative reproduction in the higher plants is leaves. Okay, in the leaf it will be produced in the adventitious buds. Normally what is the adventitious buds? So normally bud it will be produced in the axils of the leaves or terminal of the leaf. But here the vegetative buds are produced in the margin of the leaves. This is the bryophyllum plant is the example. The bryophyllum plant, succulent. Okay, succulent leaf. And the notches it will be seen in the margin of the leaf. In the notches only they produce in the buds. Okay, these buds it will be producing outside of the leaf. Epi means outside. Fillless means, fill means leaf. Okay, outside of the leaf it will be produced in the buds. That buds it will be known as the epifillous buds. These buds, when it is the dry of this leaf, otherwise it is detached from the mother plant or this leaf. When it is touching the soil, it will be germinated into the or forms a root system and it will be developed into the new individual. Natural vegetative reproduction. Only one parent only required for this natural vegetative reproduction. So when it is produced in the individuals, no, all the individuals are genetically identical individuals. Some of the plants they are having rapidly spread. Okay, easily it will spread the species. Example, Phoenix. Then this natural vegetative reproduction it will be used in many fields. For example, horticulture, farmer, and so they are using the single organ. It will be having disturbed characters. They will be cultivate more plants from that organism. So they will be used for the cultivation, harvested, and large scale. Then come to the disadvantages. When it is having the advantages also, it will be having only one disadvantages. What is the advantages? There is no genetic variation. Okay, they produce in the new plants. So in that new plants, there is no genetic variation. Because here there is no gametic fusion. So what is the mother plant it will be having? The same character it will be pass in the next generation. So that's why it is not showing any genetic variation. So in the already now we studied the natural method of vegetative reproduction. Now we are going to discuss about the artificial method of natural vegetative method. Sorry. Artificial method. Okay. The artificial method means, so they use some techniques in the plants. Through that techniques, they are obtaining the many plants in the method of the vegetative reproduction. So that is used in agriculture, horticulture. So because they needed the some of the purpose, the leaves are colorful flowers. So that purpose it will be used. So some artificial propagation, it will be used by man by longer time. So that longer time itself it will be started to use, you know, that methods it will be called the conventional method. So this conventional method it will be classified into three types, cutting, grafting, layer. Then that newer method is nowadays they use the technology. So applying that technology and open the large number of the plants in the shorter period itself. So that method it will be called the modern method. So that modern methods example tissue culture, micro propagation. So artificial method it will be classified into two types, conventional method and modern methods. First we are going to see about the conventional method. So in the conventional method, three types it will be there. The first one cutting. So the cutting again it will be classified into three types: root cutting, stem cutting, leaf cutting. So cutting nothing but in the plant portion. Okay, suppose it will be a root or stem or leaf portion, it will be cut, and the suitable medium when it is deep, you know, in that time it will be giving the next generation is called the conventional method or cutting method. So that methods, okay, based on which portion it will be using, it will be classified three types. No, first one root cutting example Malus, stem cutting example Hibiscus, Bougainvillea, Moringa. So it will be used commonly. We are using this stem cutting method. Then leaf cutting Begonia, Bryophyllum. Okay, leaf portion. The margin will be produced in the apical parts already listed, you know, the same thing. The cryophyllum leaf also will be produced in the next generation. Then, next method is grafting method. So, the grafting method already we know in the animals. Okay, the grafting, that is the transplantation. The same and only here they will be doing the grafting, joining two different plants. Okay, that join. When it is joined, you know, that joining after long time it will be continued to grow the two species and produce in the same plant. Okay, in that time it will be needed the two different plants. So one is the stalk, another one is scion. So stalk nothing but which plant it will be having the contact with the soil, that plant is stalk, and which plant is grafting along with that stalk, that plant is called scion. Example citrus, mango, apple, these plants could be done the grafting. So the grafting based on the uniting, okay, where it will be joining or where it will be grafting, you know, based upon that it will be classified into five types. The first one, bud grafting. So bud grafting, so in the bud it will be doing the T-shaped incision in the stem portion. It is the stalk plant, that is the soil touching plant. So T-shaped incision it will be done and fixing the plant, okay, that is the scion, it will be added in the place, and after that it will be taping. Okay, so we are covering fully here. So after some days, that is 3 to 4 months, it will be unite and join to produce the both the character in that patch. That's crunch. Then second one, approach grafting. Here approach grafting. So one is the root, both the plants are rooted plant. One is the stalk is the larger plant. And scion it will be grafted plant. No, it is also potted plant, but it is the thin. One is thick and another one is the thin portion. Here it will be doing some incision and removing the bark region, and it will be covered. Okay, that is the approach grafting. And third one is tongue grafting. So here it will be cutted into the tongue shape. Okay, stalk it will be having roots, and scion it will be not having the root. Okay, rootless plant. Okay, it is the grafted plant. So how it will be fixing through that, where it will be having the tongue cavity, no? So in that cavity it will be fixed perfectly. So that type of the grafting it will be called the tongue grafting. Then fourth one, crown grafting. Crown means in the stalk plant it will be cutted into the, what is that, flower. Okay, in that case it will be doing the some hole, and the remaining pieces it will be taken for the grafting. So it will be fixed into that the stalk plant and cultivating. So it is the upper portion of that stalk it will be done this grafting. So it will be called the crown grafting. Then wedge grafting, wedge shape, that is the upper. So the wedge shape it will be cutted into the scion plant, and it will be inserted into the stalk. So in that stalk it will be fixed and taped. So later both the TMDM and everything it will be mixed together and joined, and it will be both the branches it will be having both the plant characters. Okay, so it is the totally five types of grafting method. Then third one it will be a, what is that, layering method. Okay, what is layering? The stem it is not cut from the parent plant. Okay, so it will be retained in the plant parent itself, and the branches it will be a flexible branches. So it will be bended into the soil and buried into the soil. So after 2 or 3 months it will be producing the roots. Then that plant it will be cut from the mother plant. So that is called the layering method. Example, Ixora and Jasmine. So in this layering also, two types it will be having, mock layering and air layering. So mock layering means the flexible branch it will be buried into the soil or ground. So then it will be exposed to the soil, then it will be passed, what is that, emergency, that roots, after that it will be cut and develop into the new individual, that is normal layering, it will be called the mock layering. Then second type, so it is the picture for the mock layering. The flexible branch it will be buried into the soil, that branch lower portion will start producing the root system, after that it will be cut, it is forms the new individual. Then second type is air layering. So here the grid is, okay, where is the node it will be seen, you know, in the plant, on the plant nodular region it will be gridded in that place, and they are applying some other hormones, for example auxin. So auxin it will be added. So add, and it will be moist soil it will be covered in that places, and after the mud they will be covering the one polythene sheet. So it will leave 2 to 4 months. Here we can see the joint in the face. Okay. So here it will start producing the roots. When it is cut this branch and it will cultivate into the separate part, it will be produced the new implant. So this type of the layering it will be called the air layering. Then what is the advantages of conventional method? So here all the plants genetically uniform. So because mother parent what is having the character, the same character it will be produced in the that daughter, that is the next generation also. And many plants it will be produced very quickly in this method. So if you are doing any cutting or layering, how many pieces and how many places you are buried in the soil, so it will be produced at that number of the plants. And here produce a little or no seeds. That's why the plant it will be used the this layering or cutting method. Suppose it will be producing the seeds also, that seeds is not germinate. So that's why it will be using in the shorter period itself in the cultivation. And it is the more economically important Solanum tuberosum. The tubers it will be used to produce the next generation, because in the tubers we can see the depression. That depression, it will be called the ice pot. That ice pot, it will be used for the germination. And two different disturbed character, it will be needed in the same plant. So that time we can use the method is crafting method. That crafted, we can get a new plant. That new plant will be having the same disturbed character. And this advantage is of the combination method. Suppose if you are taking that egg plant or parent plant, it will be infected. That is bacterial or viral infected plants if you take. They produce the young one or all individuals or new individuals, all it will be affected. Then second one, vegetative structures. Okay, it will be used for the propagation in the bulky. So sometimes it will be bulky when it will be used. Not many species it will be produced, or it will be handled, or storage also it is very difficult. This too, it is the disadvantages of combination method. In next class, we can continue. This class, we will see the topic reproduction and types. And in that type, asexual reproduction, again, it will be divided into the natural and artificial. Then that types also we studied. And about the angiosperm reproduction, we can see the next class.